Welcome back to the Tacomaholic channel, everybody. In this video, we will be going over the first $500 I think you should spend on your Tacoma build. Now, if $500 sounds like a lot of money to be throwing into your Tacoma, then you probably haven't been shopping around. I think you might be surprised at how quick the money can start to flow. And the best thing about all the things I'll be going over today, they are
gender neutral,
meaning they apply to second and third gen Tacomas. So let's get started. And all of the things I will be going over today are great for your Tacoma build, regardless of what type of build you're going for. So you could be going for a mall crawler build, an off-roading or wheeling build, or just a simple camping build, which I don't have any footage for yet. All right, guys, we will be starting off in the bed today, but as I go through everything you see in today's video, if you see anything you like, there will be links for everything in the video description below. And for more sweet Tacoma-related links, don't forget to check out my Facebook page right here. So first on the list is the Tacoma bed mat. This one is genuine Toyota. There are a few aftermarket counterparts, but I like this one. It says Tacoma. It's definitely a sweet mod to have because it looks good, for one. It is super functional, if you did not know. The Tacoma bed, second and third gen, is a composite material. And when that stuff gets wet, it is super slippery. I discovered that by almost busting my ass the first time I cleaned my truck, and this was wet back here, and I was trying to wipe down the roof over there and almost fell right on my head and hurt myself. This will not only keep you planted if you're back here like wiping stuff off after a wash, whatever you put back here, as long as it's not round, will pretty much stay in place. This is super grippy. Holds all your stuff in place and of course protects the bed from getting damaged. There are short and long bed versions of the Tacoma bed mat from Toyota, priced about the same. Usually the higher end is about $125. Well worth it in my opinion. And next on the list while we are back here with the bed are some bed stiffeners. Now the ones I have specifically are from Total Chaos. They are at the upper end of the price spectrum. These can usually be had for about $100. They are functional in keeping your bed sides with your bed at a 90 degree angle right here, because usually when you start to add weight on the back of your bed, like with a bed rack or maybe a rooftop tent or any combination of that, and you go off-roading, that can start to make the bedside separate out from the center, ruining that angle, of course, causing damage over time. The bed stiffener is sort of like an insurance policy to help keep that from happening. They just bolt right in here on the side and use one of the bed bolts right there, obviously one for either side. So these are super functional for keeping your bed from separating, but also, as you can see with this one specifically, they have tons of mounting points for D-rings you could put on the bottom or bungee cords, stuff like that. This specifically is for like a radio spring mount or anything like that. You could even put like a light bar on here with some kind of bracket. And some of these, mine didn't come with it and I'm sort of bummed about it, but some of these even have a beer bottle opener like integrated into the side right there. Like I mentioned before, you can usually get a pair of these for about $100. Even if you have the JBL upgrade on your second or third gen Tacoma, I have heard that it's really not that good. It doesn't sound as good as what you would expect considering the price tag that adds onto the truck. So I'm going to recommend you replace all of your door speakers. If you have a double cab like I do, the fronts are 6x9s, the rear doors are 6.5s. Now there are of course plenty of brands you can go with. I went with the Rockford Fosgate. I'll link them down below. It is a set of all four, and I will include the adapters that let you plug these speakers in to the factory wiring harness. So it is literally plug and play, about $100. Major upgrade for your audio system. Now just keep in mind, obviously you don't have a subwoofer included with that or an amplifier, but I think you will be pleasantly surprised with how much better you can make the factory stereo in your Tacoma, factory head unit sound, just with a quick door speaker upgrade.
What is this new devilry?
Now you may have noticed my hood is floating as if by magic. I don't have one of those old school hood props. Now my truck did come with that, but I have the Red Line Tuning hood struts right here. Where's the logo? There it is right there. Now when I got these, Red Line Tuning was the only company that made hood struts for the Tacoma. I think it's either Stryker or Spiker Engineering. Let me know down in the comments which one it is, but I believe they also make some hood struts now for the Tacoma, similarly priced. about $100, but if you're going to be doing any maintenance on your truck or adding accessories, all that stuff, it might sound stupid, but it's just a pain having to deal with the hood prop, especially when I don't even remember which way it opens. I think it's propped over in this corner. It's just, it always seems like it's in the way when you're reaching in there, say to change your air filter or do anything like that. So having the hood struts is super convenient. They look awesome, the install is easy, and you can get them for about $100. There are a few options that sort of make these more expensive, specifically for the Redline tuning. I think they make like a stainless steel version, and I think they even have like a carbon fiber boot on the end or something like that, but that just adds to the price. These are the Quick Lift Plus, if I remember correctly. I've had these for about 5 years on the truck. I actually have had these longer than I've been doing vids for the channel on YouTube, so there's no installation for video on that. Hopefully maybe I can get one of my local Tacoma buddies who's going to install one of these. I could film that process for you guys. You might be wondering, well, why doesn't Toyota just include hood struts with the Tacoma from the factory like it seems like every other manufacturer? Well, the answer is always cost. That might not sound like a lot, but when you're talking about adding that to the whatever 20,000 or 30,000 Tacomas they sell a year, if not higher, that adds up quickly, eats into their profits. So definitely recommend grabbing a set of the hood struts. Ugh. And while we're back here, the cheapest item on the list, I hate to say cheap, the least expensive, is the pop and lock locking tailgate handle. Now, if you have a third gen, I believe all of the handles lock from the factory, so obviously you don't have to worry about that. But us second gen guys, that never was an option. So, and of course, if you did not realize, it is super easy to steal this tailgate. It takes about 5 seconds with some snips to cut off the wire for the camera right there. But the pop and lock locking tailgate handle, I've had mine on the truck for about 4 years now. Zero issues with it. I squirt a little WD-40 into the keyhole a couple times a year just to keep everything clean and lubricated. They come in different colors. I just got the flat black, and it looks like I need to like clean it a little. I've got a little stainage right there, but really not too bad. I've had zero issues with it, and of course, yes, it locks. This is the less expensive version that actually uses your ignition key. You can key it to that. They do have an electronic one that works with your door locks if you want to grab that. That was probably about $100, but the less expensive version like I have, usually around $70, $60 to $70, depending on if you get some kind of discount or anything, but highly recommend this. Protect your tailgate, because I want to say a painted tailgate from the factory probably going to cost you about $1,000, or obviously whatever your insurance deductible is. So locking tailgate handle, gotta have it for your second gen Tacoma. And as a bonus six item, this isn't counted towards the 500 because obviously it would push that over, I'm going to recommend floor mats for your Tacoma, specifically all weather floor mats. I have the WeatherTechs. I've also heard the Huskies are great. Had these for years, zero issue. And look, plenty of dirt and stuff all over the carpet. And again, regardless of the type of build you're going for, you could be living in a northern state where there's tons of road salt. You don't want that on your carpet down here, for one, but even just factory floor mats, they're not going to cut it. These, it's like a bowl. I have about a half inch lip right here where it literally holds everything in there. You can pull the entire thing out, pressure wash it, hose it down, it's good to go. Had these for years. They seem indestructible, and the color is holding up nicely as well. All right, everybody, those are my recommendations for how you should spend the first $500 on your Tacoma build, regardless of what type of build you are going for. There is, of course, plenty of overlap between all of the different types of Tacoma builds, but each of them is truly unique. If you plan on getting one of these items for yourself, comment below, let me know what it is. And if you think I left out something important that you would have personally added to the list, comment below, let me know. As always, thank you so much for supporting the Tacomaholic channel by watching this video. Help the channel grow just a little bit by sharing it with your friends on social media. Enjoy the rest of your week, and I'll see you in the next video.